Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. We're doing well. Just picked up one of these battery banks from Growatt. Reason why I bought this is I've got some MPT controllers on my main solar setup out in the garage, and I've had these for over 7 years without any hiccups. Touch wood. So I decided to pick up one of these and we're going to have a look at it. There's the box it came in. Yeah, it's a picture on the side, some information on that side, nothing there, nothing there, and so on. So we can get a shot of that and we can have a look at this. Hopefully that keeps focused. Nice little packaging. It's got some information on the top if you need to give them a call, website and so on. Growatt do loads of different size ones. This one's the latest one in this model, which we'll talk about. There's the box, some information on the sides, you got your outputs, which we'll discuss, inputs, and different ways to charge it and such. And it has a maximum power storage of 537 watt hours. So you've got 537 watts you can use. And if you use that in 1 hour, that's what it'll use. That's your inverter, pure sine wave. So it'll be good for computers, anything like that. And that's the type of battery, which is a lithium phosphate battery, lithium iron phosphate. Yeah, so let's get this thing open, because I'm really excited about this. I ummed and ahed about different makes, Lowetti stuff, and I decided to go for this because of what I've already got and what you've got in your nose. So like, I'm quite happy with what I've got. But I've got to like change my glasses to see that. But all this is pretty easy to see. Yeah, so that's great. And then obviously you've got some foam at the top, which is well protected. Get out of the road. And then I'll just tip it up so you can see. There's the unit. And it looks like some cables. So we'll get everything out. Box of cables. Some more quick user guide on the side, that's just nice. Accessory kit. More packaging, which is always nice. And then we've got some silica gel. There's like three silica gels in there. Okay, let's get this out. Okay, nothing else in the box. So I can move the box out of the road. And there's the unit. We'll just open it now. It comes well packaged. There you go. Just making a little bit of space. Right, wow. So, first impressions, I like it, it looks really nice. It's quite weighty, I don't know what the weight is, we'll have to check that in the manual. But it's portable. I mean, it just, I like things with weight. It feels like you get something. I like where if it's light, you think, oh, it's got less batteries in, I want more batteries, more weight. So I don't mind that. So, you've got your wireless charger at the top. It's plastic, but that feels like metal. I know it's plastic, but it's got that cold feel to it, like as if it's aluminium, which is good. You've got some screws all the way around the side, and these ones are star ones if you are going to take it a bit. And when you click the handle, it locks into place, which I really like that. And it feels like a handle, like, it doesn't feel like it's flexible, it's going to move, it feels solid. Along the top you've got some rubber trim, and then you've got your wireless charging at the top. Put all the specs on the all the specs up there. Saves me going through the manual because I've literally just opened it. Round to this side, we have an app. So you can scan Google Play, App Store to get your software for your phone. There's your wireless charging. Pop that on, if it's turned on, it'll start charging. There's three actual units in there, so you don't have to worry about being trying to find it. Just plonk it down and it should work. I'll try that as well. Around this side, we've got inlet. On the other side's the outlet. It's QR code, so you can scan them to get the software for your phone. This side, excuse me while I sneeze. It's gone. There's the other outlet, and there's a fixing for there. And we've got a little door which stays up. Yeah, which is nice. Let me just turn these lights on. I forgot to turn the lights on. Might be a bit clearer. There you go. XT60 for, this is all input by the way. So you're charging this up off something else. Wall socket, solar, whatever you decide to charge it from. And there's the sockets there. Yeah, XT60 mains. And then you've got this button which gives you a boost up to a boost input charge. Yeah. And we'll have a look at that later on. Nothing on the back. And then the other side's there. There's the front. I'm just trying to lean it over so you can see. So you don't get too much glare. USBs, there's four of them. Type A, about 2.0 something amp. Then we've got the fast charger, which is 18 watt. That one, and then we've got 100 watt type C, which is excellent. The other ones have got the same type of thing. If I show you that, if we can see, you've got that one's a 60 watt though, so it's obviously a lot less. But the similar type of thing, this is a 100 watt fast charger, which is a lot. We all have these buttons, so you can turn them on and off. You got the Wi-Fi button, which we look into, and then you've got your AC power. I'm in the UK, so it's 240 volts, 600 watt max, but I think it peaks to like 1000 just for a short time so it doesn't trip. They'll all look good. They're actually upside down because most adapters stick up, which is a nice feature. They should be the other way really in the house, the other way. But that's a nice touch because they've thought about that. You've got the DC power. This is all coming out. So barrel connectors, which I actually use. If you notice there, you've got DC input there. So I've got a cable, so I could actually charge this up off that. Straight off that type of thing. That's the only one I've actually got. I could have to push charge this up off there, but there's no point. I don't see the point of that really, but yeah, so barrel connectors, and then we've got this connector here, which is like a camping socket, cigarette light type of socket. I have quite a few of these items which I can plug into them, so I quite like them. On me, in the shed, I have a bank, about four of these, and for charging up from the batteries to other things. Nice silicon plug, which is good. Same as on the top, that's silicon, and that's really it. So on the bottom, we've got some nice feet, rubber feet, just to show you. Yeah, that's nice and sticky, which is good. Right, let's turn this thing on and have a little look, and we'll move that quick. So hold it down. It's got some charge in it, which is great. 35% input, output. Straightforward, nice and clear. A light. Spot on, I love these things. And then like a rescue mode off. A little green light to see if these are powered coming out, probably devices. which is good. AC, you can see there, 240 volts, 230 volts, 50 hertz. And I'll see the output, and you can turn it off. You hear the click as well, you can hear the click of better. This is a sine wave, pure, just clean signal. And we'll stick the scope on that and have a look as well. And then DC outlet is that. So I like that there's little lights on there. And obviously we're gonna connect this. I'll try that now to see whether the wireless works. See, it's just, I'll just plunk it on anywhere. Nothing. Yeah, somewhere in the middle. And 90%. I don't know what the rate is. Oh, look at my time here. Oh, we've got 19 hours. How's that? 19 hours, 19.8 hours left remaining in that 35%. And it's a 5 watts. I assume that's 0.44 watts of charge. That's cool. Yeah, 91%. So that's that. Let's have a look in this box. Accessory box. Then we're going to get this thing charged up. Cables. You've got your XT60 cable to that, which I really need for my solar charging this up. You've got a kettle plug, that's good, 13 amp. And then we've got this one, which has got our XT60 and the solar connectors. And a nice length of cable. I don't know what that is, but it looks like it's going to be like 4 feet, 10 feet or something. I don't know, we'll check that out later on, but that's great. Right guys, I want to get this charged up and then move on. So what we're going to do is, I'm going to charge this up. Do some tests, see how much we can. There's a 530 something watt hours. We'll see what we can get out of these batteries. Lithium iron phosphate batteries, so they're great. And we'll get the app working as well. We'll have a look at that, and I'll stick it on the bench and we'll just see. So, back shortly. Okay, so I've decided to plug it into the solar. Into my solar, which you can see there, it's plugged in. Hopefully you see that screen closer. So we can see we've got input of 90 watts, 3.7 hours remaining to charge it up at that 90 watts. Bear in mind, it's only coming in from my from one of these sockets on my solar. So take 3 hours to charge it up from 35%. Okay, so it's been on load test for about 2.5 hours or something. Let me just show you. Hopefully I don't trip this off or do anything where it knocks it off. So we're at 12.3 volts, pulling just under 6 amps. I've lowered the amps because this plug's getting a bit hot. I'll show you that. It's cooled down now, but it was at 7 amps, 8 amps. And we've done, so far, 47%, 240 watt hours. Just leave that there. It's finished its tests. We're at 0 on the Growatt. And I've done it all through this socket, which is a maximum of 10 amp, which is a lot. And what happened is, I'll show you the results first. So I won't, that'll focus. Just give me a second. I'll try to focus on that. Hopefully you can pick that up anywhere. We've got 454.90 watt hours, 6 hours on the test. I had to do it again and start again because I forgot to zero this out, so Yeah, that's the test. Now, it didn't get the full 537 watt hours. That's under perfect conditions. These aren't. I also think it says in the manual, I'm almost sure, that you're supposed to drain the battery down to zero, then take it back up three times to get the memory effects all sorted. Maybe it's something to do with that. Now, if I'd done the same test with these running a load, it'd be different again, because the conversion ratio from DC to AC is going to be a lot less on that. I'd personally use these or these for doing all my work. I'm really interested in these and that. Not so much these, because I know I don't like losing anything, and you're going to lose quickly. But they are there for emergency. For my opinion, they work 600 with a maximum of 1,000 peak. So I think it's a 15 watt wireless charger on the top. So that's good. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to pop it back on the solar charger, because I charged it up using solar. I'll put a video up, I'll see if I can do that. But I charged it up with solar, it's about 100 watts going in. It will take the socket here will take 200, I believe. But I was getting anywhere from, like, when the sun was out, 100, and that was the limitations of my socket, because on my solar board, solar comes in, goes through the battery, solar batteries, and then it comes out to a distribution board which has some of these on. So I'm going from that to, from on my solar to this. So that's 10 amps maximum mine, so that was given as about 100 watts, so that's why that was only 100 going in, which I prefer. And it took about three and a half hours or something. And when the sun went in, it dropped down to 50 and stuff, but done really well. So I'm really chuffed with these. I'd love to be able to try the smaller version and the bigger versions. I'd love to try the full range, to be honest. Next, I'm going to have to figure out a way to test the solar part of it out, and also I'm going to test, I'll do a quick test of the pass through for the uninterrupted power supply, UPS. I'll do that, plug it into. Okay, right guys, I've got this set up, controlling the fish tank, as you can see. I've got the inverter down there. Let me just put the camera down a little bit. I thought you could see that. There you go. So you can see it's plugged in, it's turned on. Turned on there. So mains power is bypassing through. What I'm going to do now, I've turned the fish tank on, unplug the mains, or turn the mains off, which is going into there. There's a socket just over there. I need to get round to switch it off. It's actually in that corner, just round there. Them sockets are just the ones feeding it. So we've got 100% on the battery. It says we've got 1.1 hours remaining. That'll be once I turn it off, it'll just stay like that, yeah? So what I'll do is I'll go and walk over there and switch the power off and see what happens. Power's off now. There's a little flick of the light. The light, the main LEDs flickered for a split second. Pump stayed on. The heaters are on now. So we pull them. It's about, I can't see there without looking, but 356 watts. That's with both heaters on, the light on, the pump at the bottom, UV light, and the filter. So that's an a really good test. Obviously that's there. It says 1.1 hours like that. So as a UPS, that's absolutely brilliant. Obviously it'll last longer because the heat is only staying for about 3 minutes, and then they'll go off for about an hour and so on. And obviously the lights you can turn up and down. So you probably get longer than that. It still says 1.1 hours, still 100%. Right guys, so that's half it done. Right guys, so to finalise this video off for this power station, I just thought I'd go over a few little things. So main thoughts are, I'm really happy. In fact, I'm so happy I ended up getting another one. I ordered the second one. It's been a few days in between videos and things, and I was so impressed with the first one. I've marked it up number two and number one because 500 watt hours, I just needed a bit more. So I thought, while one's on charge, I can charge the one up, and it's like that. I would really like to try the different versions out, different size ones of the, these Growatt ones. Maybe some solar panels. I don't have any flexible solar panels to try, but I'd like to try that. Maybe a 200 watt folding panel, and also the different size. I'd love to get the next one up and try the different sizes, maybe. So I'm looking into that. So overall, the look, the quality of the materials is premium. It looks more expensive than you'd expect to pay a lot more for it. The app is fantastic. Now I've obviously got two on the app, so I can check both. It's got all the information on that app, what you need to check the amps, the watts, temperatures, literally just to monitor it. It's fantastic. The fans, I think initially I said this was in, this one's out, goes in this side and out obviously the other side there. So that's actually good. It's quite noisy, but that proves that the fans come on and it cools it down. I did use the, what did I use? If I can find it, I can't find it. Every time you put something down, you lose it, so I don't know what it's gone to. There it is. So I did use, put them on the floor. I did use a thermal camera to monitor the heat spots. Now this did get a little bit warm at 10 amps. I would, if it was me, up to me, I'd like to see an option where you could switch it down to 5 amps or 10 amps in case you're not in a rush, because it does get a little bit warm. And that's probably not to do with this, it's probably to do with the connector you buy, which doesn't come from this company. Sometimes you get cheap versions. I haven't got none here. No, I haven't got one. Yeah, it's downstairs. I should have brought it. Maybe it's downstairs. I can't get to it. But the connector that goes in off different companies, sometimes you can get really cheap ones. So that could be a factor. So yeah, what we're going to use this for then? I'm going to use this to solely charge it off solar panels. And then I'm going to use this, I want it to use it for battery backup for my fish tank. I've got a video of that, you've probably seen it, so there's a link just somewhere, but yeah. And also for my fridge, so I want one for the fridge, one for the backup. I don't know, I haven't done a tester yet because it's 7 months of time, but I might need to get the bigger version. Although that's depending on whether I can afford to spend more money on this. But yeah, if this works, that'd be great. If it doesn't, I'll have to probably find a way to get another one, a bigger version. But for other things I charge, like drones, and there's my drone there, so I use it for charging my drone. When I'm going out, charge things like that. I've got like about 10 different types of drones. All my radio gear for that. Multiple flashlights. So for charging like the smaller items, I think these are just absolutely fantastic. There's a bunch of flashlights, and I've got more. Charging 18650s, these are all done off here, and then use this to charge it off the main solar panels. So you're charging up your 18650s, these type of things in there, so that's great. What else then? So many things. USB, there's a soldering iron which uses 70 watts. So now we've got a portable solar station, a solar soldering station. What else? Let's have a look. I thought that was great. There's a little 3D pen, USB. This thing uses 10-15 watts, so it gets up to 300 centigrade. For I use a 3D pen for repairing plastic, so if there's a crack in the plastic, I can rebuild it and then melt it back in. So that's what I use that for. So that's another item. Put that over there. Cameras, this one's a thermal camera, just the same as the other one was. That's a like indoor one. It's all USB type C, so all these could be charged off things like this. That one's a monocular, thermal monocular for hunting. What else? Little lights. You got these USB lights. These things will last forever. They use 0.0 bloody watts. They can be plugged in and angled around. Different things. So them are really good. And the list goes on. I'll just show you one final thing before I move on to the things. This is a little compressor. Little for spraying like models. This has its own Intel battery. I'll just show you. It's turned on. Obviously it doesn't work when I need it to. Is that on or off? Yeah, it's on. You don't hold it in, you just push it on. Sometimes, nearly everything you get, you've got to hold it in for 3 seconds. This one doesn't. So you can see it's not plugged in, but you could plug it into there and then into the 12 volts, because it's 12 volts powered. And it still works, but then this will be chopping it back up. So that's fantastic, I love that. It's just because it's portable, it's just easy to use. So yeah, the things you can use, they're all 18650s. The things you can use is just so much useful what these can be. And like I say, I'm really happy with the quality. One other thing, if Growatt's listening, the wireless charger, which is 15 watt for phones, is great. But I'm a bit concerned if I decide to put this one on top of there to stack them, would the magnetic field affect the bottom? Is there anything in the bottom? I don't know. But I'd like it if there was a button. That would be good. Something to look at. So you can physically turn it off. I don't like it being on. Just for instance, say for instance I was using that, and that's a recorder, would it wipe the memory or a memory card or something? So I think it'd be better with a button on off, just like the other ones. I think that would be the final touch. But the material of the plastic, I think it's ABS. It feels really premium. It's got like a textured, this feels like metal. It's plastic, but it feels like metal. So I'm really pleased with that. It's nice and solid, clicks into place. Everything on it works good. I've tried everything out. The light's good, just everything really. I've charged it up 3 or 4 times now to try it out. It's all been done off solar. I've charged it off mains just to try it, to see if it works, and it does. The only thing, I've tried everything to be honest. The only thing I'm not sure about whether we could link, is it possible to link these two together to run, to double the watt hours? I don't think you can, but if anyone knows, I'd appreciate that. Leave in the comments below. Bought one, so impressed, bought another one, and I'll probably buy more. But I'd like to do reviews of the full range of these. And solar panels and things, because I'm just so impressed with the quality of them. Yeah, and for what you're getting, these are my new favourite things to check out. So guys, if you've got any comments, drop it in the list below, and I'll try to answer them if I can. But yeah, highly recommend these. These are nice, and there's 3 or 4 different models. So there's a model smaller than this, and then there goes this one, then another couple bigger, 1300 watt hours and 1500 or 1600 watt hours, I think. I haven't really looked at them too much because I only look at what I can buy. I don't look at some things I can't really get, so that's why I didn't really look at them ones. But overall, absolutely fantastic. I'll keep you updated how these go. Again, I bought these myself, so it's an honest review. If they were no good, I would say stay away from them, but so far I'm really, really pleased with the quality of them. Leave in the comment below, give us a like, give us a sub if you haven't, so I appreciate it. Any comments, I'll try to get back to you. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you next one. Cheers.